Our next presenter is Tessa. Talk nice and loud.
The person who I'm researching is Laura Ingalls Wilder. She was born on February 7, 1867. Where she was born was Pepin, Wisconsin. She died on February 10, 1957 at her Rocky Ridge farm. Laura was six and got the scarlet fever. She got malaria and almost died. In 1875, grasshoppers ate all their food that was grown. Ma made furniture, hunted, and made their house. Ma and the girls sewed and made food. Laura loved reading books. She loved school and was smart. On August 25, 1885, Laura and Almanzo Wilder married. She lived on a farm with Almanzo. Laura was a teacher and an author. On December 5, 1886, their daughter Rose was born. When Laura was 65, her first book was published. It was called Little House in the Big Woods. In 1954, the Laura Ingalls Wilder Award was created for Laura. Laura wrote 9 books. She was an author and a teacher. Laura had one child. Laura was a pioneer and was a pioneer for her whole life. Laura describes her books very well. Laura is so grateful. She was a teacher and some kids were older than her. Laura was important because she wrote books about her pioneer life. I like that she lived on a farm. I also like that she was a pioneer. People still enjoy reading her books today.
Read any of the Little House on the Prairie books or watched the TV shows? Yes. So that is who Tessa is speaking about. Real person who wrote these amazing books. Any other questions? Ella?
I don't know
what it says on the map. Well, we're going to get to that. Okay. So Tessa, would you like to talk about your compare and contrast? What do you feel you have similar to Laura Ingalls?
We both like dogs, we both write books, we both go to school, we both do chores, we both have one brother, we both live in Wisconsin, we both live by a woods, and we both have a garden.
Nice, I like it. And your map, what does that show?
That shows all the places she's been and lived.
Wow, so those are all states that she lived in. Really? So can you show us what that is? So she was born in Wisconsin.
Yeah. And then she went to Kansas and Oklahoma, right there. And then she moved back to Pepin, Wisconsin. And then she went to Walnut Grove, Minnesota. And then she moved to Burr Oak, Iowa, and then just met Dakota, moved there, and Mansfield, Missouri.
Wow, I didn't realize that she lived in so many different states. That's amazing. What about your word cloud? What did you put for your word cloud?
She was loving, grateful, very caring, helpful, and smart.
Very nice. And can you explain the picture that you drew of Laura?
So they went over a big river, and it was in the winter, and it cracked, but they made it just in time.
Ooh, that's scary. What about any of your pictures? I see that you have some really lovely pictures. Now, I'm assuming those, the top ones are Laura. Mm-hmm. What about the bottom ones? Who are they?
This is Almanzo, and this is her daughter, Rose.
Very nice. And Almanzo is who?
Her husband.
Very nice. Anything else you would like to share on your poster?
These are all her books.
Oh, nice. What would you like to read them off?
So these Happy Golden Years. On the banks of Plum Creek, the first 4 years, the long winter, by the shores of Silver Lake, little town on the prairie, little house in the big woods, little house since she was 65. So I don't really know. It doesn't really say.
Well, if it was published in 65, that's when the book was presented to the public. So she probably worked on it quite a while before that, but published it when she was 65. And then she wrote all of those books. I love her little book pictures. It's so fun. Spectacular job. Any other questions for Ms. Ingalls?
Well, I have a comment. I have The Little House on the Prairie.
Yes, I have the whole series, and I love them as a little girl. they're spectacular books. So very, very nice. Good job. Wow.
Bravo.